you so much. My name is Victor. I'm a member of Sandbox Percussion. We are a percussion quartet based in nearby, in Brooklyn, New York. And we are super thrilled to be here. This is our final concert for the NYU Sandbox Percussion Seminar 2022, our seventh annual seminar. Thanks so much to everyone who's here in person and to the people on the live stream who are joining us. We have some people joining us on our YouTube channel as well. So thank you so much for being here. For the past 2 years, this seminar has been virtual. It's happened all on Zoom. And that was a lot of fun, and we did a lot of really great, interesting projects. But man, I'm so pumped to have had this last week playing music in person with my colleagues, with all the incredible participants who have been here with us all week. It's been a real joy, so we're really, really pumped to share all this music with you. We have a lot of different kind of set changes and things that will be happening on the stage. Different groups are going to be coming up and moving some instruments around, so bear with us a little bit. I think we got it all sussed out. We have a good plan. But we're super pumped to be here to be playing this for you. I'm gonna keep this brief because we got some music to get to. The first piece on the program is Pillar 3 by Andy Kehoe. It's gonna take place over here on this vibraphone, metal pipes, some various kind of auxiliary sounds, crotales, grand casa, bass drum flipped on its side, lots of really interesting, fun sounds. So I'll invite the first group up here to play Pillar 3 by Andy Kehoe. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you. little bit more about the next piece on the program while some things happen behind me on stage. Before I do that, I'll share a little bit more about what we do at the seminar and maybe a little bit about what we did this week with all the students. As you can see on the program, we pick some of these pieces that Amy Sandbox plays pretty regularly, and we program them with one of us and a group of students who are joining us. And, you know, I was listening to the sound check this morning, and I was pretty blown away by just how rich and personal the interpretations of this music sound to me. Again, these are pieces that I've performed the Sandbox 50, 100 times, whatever it is, and I'm listening to this music in a completely different way. And for me, that's like absolutely one of my favorite parts of this week, is not just getting to meet all these percussionists from around the country, but actually collaborating with them deeply, making something together that is new. To me, that's incredibly special, and again, all of that happens in 5 days of rehearsal, which is somewhat remarkable. So another thing we think about a lot during the week at the seminar, we talk about entrepreneurship and Sandbox's career, how we got to where we are today and how we do what we do, how we get to do what we do. I think one of the things we've been thinking about more and more lately in the past few years is just how we really couldn't be here if it weren't for the four of our parents and families. And so I want to give a quick shout out to many of the parents who are here in the audience today, who are watching on the stream, and who definitely made all of this actually happen. So thanks to all of those parents. I think we all know how many hours of music lessons are currently standing on stage right now. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the next piece that the students are playing. This is a piece by a good friend of Sandbox's, Chris Cerrone. It's titled A Natural History of Vacant Lots. Again, this is another quartet that utilizes two vibraphones and then a series of somewhat unique instruments that Chris has sort of handcrafted himself, or sort of picked out himself. So you'll notice some glockenspiel bars, some wine glasses, some crotales, some tuned metal pipes that we went to the hardware store and cut to be the mostly correct lengths so that they're in tune with those vibraphones. And again, what is created with this kind of amalgamation of instruments is a mostly perfect set of pitches. And so what Chris is listening for in some cases is that moment where maybe those instruments aren't perfectly in tune, right? So unlike a piano, who may have had a piano tuner on stage tuning for a couple hours before tonight's performance, we are actually embracing some of that imperfection. So this piece utilizes an electronics track that Chris has sort of crafted himself, and so I know this group has really worked this week to not just work together as a quartet, but really almost as a quintet, so that they're always in dialogue with this electronics track. I know that Chris was here working really hard with them on this work, and I know I see Chris on the stream tonight, or today, this afternoon. It looks like we are pretty much ready. I'm getting a thumbs up. All right. Okay, so this is Chris Cerrone's A Natural History of Vacant Lots. Thank you again.
seen so far in the program. We spent most of our time this week rehearsing these pieces. That was really the focus of it. We were trying to dig as deeply into this music as any of us ever have before. But when we needed a break from the rehearsals, another really exciting thing that we do at the seminar every year is invite a whole bunch of guests in to work with us. So we invited some of the composers that wrote some of these pieces, like Christopher Cerrone, who wrote Vacant Lots, the piece of the electronics, Jared Saw, who wrote VV, the two vibraphone piece, Tony Olson, whose piece you're going to hear in a minute. All of them came to speak with us, both about their music, and also about the sort of interesting and unique career path that each of them chose. We try to model one version of a career path, but obviously it's a very specific one forming this chamber ensemble that we have now. And it's important to us that we try to model, try to show as many different types of careers of making a living in music as possible. So it really was such a highlight of the week to hear from all these folks. The next piece we're going to hear now is a quartet by Judah Adashi, who's a dear friend of ours who lives down in Baltimore. This is a piece called Orpheus at the Gates. This is one movement of a multi-movement piece. It's particularly meaningful to us in Sandbox because on the very first Sandbox Percussion Seminar in 2016, we presented a different movement, the world premiere actually, of a different movement of this piece. So every time we're able to program one of these pieces, it's really exciting for us. So without further ado, this is Judah Adashi's Orpheus. traditional one.